Hello everyone, this is Phoenix Animator.
Hi, I'm Froggy Lumpy. Welcome back to Sky Factory 3, episode 17, take 3.
Take 3!
Well, first, the file was too large and we couldn't get it sent over to convert to be able to edit it.
Exactly.
And then, because of that problem, somebody, not mentioning any names...
Who?
Somebody disconnected my microphone.
What? Why would that person do that? You still seem taller than me.
I don't know why.
I don't know. Anyways. Anyway,
this is the third attempt here.
This is, exactly.
The first attempt we actually, on camera, actually made all these chickens that you see right here. And since they're already made, I'm not making them again.
Right.
So what I'm going to do is just explain myself here. The whole point of this is the uranium chicken. Okay, so let's do E and then do at chicken and pull up all the chickens. The uranium chicken, if I left click on it, it tells me I'm going to need an enderpearl chicken and a redstone chicken. I already have the redstone chicken, but I did not have the enderpearl chicken. So that means, okay, I have to make an enderpearl chicken. How do I do that? Well, I need a diamond chicken and I need a nether wart chicken. Oh, well, that's great because I already have a diamond chicken, but I don't have a nether wart chicken. Okay, so how do you make a nether wart chicken? A nether wart chicken is cocoa brown chicken, again with the colored chickens, and a glowstone chicken. Now, you never see these speckled. All of the colors have speckled and they all have solid. The only thing you ever see is the solid. The only way to get these speckled ones is through the gift bags or whatever, getting them, because we actually do have the smart chicken, I think, and it's speckled looking, and we got something else too, but those are speckles. However, when the chickens actually lay the eggs, are always these solid colors here. Okay, so now you make a glowstone chicken and a cocoa brown chicken to get your nether wart chicken, which is this guy right here. Then you take your nether wart chicken. Let's see, let's look here. Nether wart chicken. And what's it used for? If we show that, the nether wart and the diamond chicken will get you the enderpearl chicken. So by putting those two together in the nesting pen, you'll get your enderpearl chicken. Now, it is interesting to note that you only have a 17% chance to get an enderpearl chicken. However, the diamond, you got a 20% chance. In other words, what I'm telling you is it was easier for us to get a diamond chicken than it was for us to get the enderpearl chicken. We had to wait longer, in other words. So we finally got the enderpearl chicken, which the enderpearl chicken is very cool. He looks like an Enderman. He's sitting out here, and he's setting out here because he's actually nesting with the redstone chicken. So again, let's pull this up. Now, the enderpearl chicken, what is it used for? The enderpearl chicken. I clicked on it. I didn't say use. There we go. Use. Press the U button when you're over top of it. So what is it used for? You can make ellurium, which that I have not made yet. I'm going to. You need glowstone with that. What was the goal here was the uranium chicken. So we need the enderpearl chicken and the redstone chicken. So we can make the uranium chicken, which is how we got the uranium chicken. So now I need to put the glowstone chicken. Take this guy out and put him back in his pen, and take the glowstone chicken and put it with the enderpearl chicken, and we'll get the ellurium chicken. That will be the final step for the big reactor part anyway. So now this has taken a while. It's been a while. So because this is the third time we've recorded. So we now have 55 uranium ingots, so now we can actually do the uranium blocks.
Yay.
For the cobblestone generator that actually bumps things up 20%. The one last thing that I wanted to mention was that I made this glass chest. Uh-huh. There's a bunch of dark utilities, a bunch of different chests, and I thought, let me see what this is. And I placed in here, you can see all of the names, the red chicken, the orange chicken, the magenta chicken, all of the colors are in here. Then there's also the log chicken, the sand chicken, the clay chicken. There's a couple of several others. When you're done with them, but you don't want to get rid of them because you might need them, for instance, that chocolate chicken. You might want to need them for other breeding. So it's real cheap, especially if you get string chicken. It's real cheap to make this. Animal net is only string and stick. And if you have the log chicken and the string chicken, you have lots of wood and lots of string. So make up a bunch of these, place the chickens in these nets, and then all you have to do by placing them in the chest is just scroll over top of them and it'll tell you which one it is. It's like, oh, okay, there you go. For instance, I needed the brown chicken, so I just pull out the brown chicken and say, hey, I need you. So then, you know, pop him out, and there you go. Put him in a nesting pen or whatever, and I'll put him back in there and then put him back in the chest when you're done and you don't have all that excess stuff that they create, because good grief, they create a lot.
They do.
That is all I have in quick and simple in a nutshell, because boy, when we recorded it the first time, it was a lot longer because we were waiting on each step we actually went through. So
it was a longer process
version.
And then the second time it was still longer than that because we were explaining it and showed some more. But I do want to make one little thing. I want to talk about one little thing real quick. Follow me.
Okay.
So, I have in my inventory...
Why am I in the air?
Why am I in the air? Because I'm flying.
Okay.
I have in my hand a golden lasso.
Oh, please tell me you have what I hope you have in that golden lasso.
If you come down here...
I shall do it.
I made these guys.
Yes.
Yeah. They didn't work.
Yeah.
My idea was terrible.
No, it wasn't, because, I mean, it should have worked.
It should have. But I think it's because they weren't low enough.
That might be true.
So, come over here.
Okay.
Down to here.
It's real dark. Ooh, it's getting dark down here. Oh. You. Aha.
I made a mob spawner.
Yeah. What was that?
That was a monster. That was a bag.
Oh, okay.
I'm now going to light up this mob spawner because it is not needed currently. And these guys do not need to be here because I now have two bats.
Oh, that's fabulous. So it was just a matter of not being low enough.
Yes, because we are in Garden of Glass version world. And that puts your default level at 86 or something like that.
Whoa, that's up there.
When you start a just general Sky Factory world, default one, you start about right here.
Ah, so we didn't go low enough.
No, we did not go low enough.
That's what it was, yeah. Because when we started, when we were down, we were on your computer and just did a regular one and had a mob spawner and... they were flying around in a regular mob spawner.
Yep, and that's what gave me the idea to start it here.
Yeah.
And just make a regular mob spawner that is on level.
Oh, that's fabulous. Now that we have our bats, and look at what I've been carrying around in my golden bag. I'm going to open it up here. I've been carrying around these drops of evil and these other golden lassos.
Wonderful.
So that we can make, and I actually have one cursed lasso. So we can make the other cursed lasso and actually have angel rings.
That sounds great.
So instead of having our jetpacks, we'll have angel flight.
That sounds wonderful.
Yeah, I like the sound of that very much so. Definitely. Alrighty then.
I think that'll be it.
I'm Froggy Lumpy.
And I'm Phoenix Animator.
Thanks ever so much for watching, everybody. Have a great day.
Hope you enjoyed the episode. And if you have any suggestions, leave them in the comments below.
Bye.
Bye. See you all later.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Cobble.